great. I'm trying to change a fluid on my high pressure oil reservoir on a 7.3. So what I did is went to Lowe's and got a coil of tubing, some copper tubing, just a cheap little coil, and then one of these cheap transfer pumps from Harbor Freight, which the lines on here are kind of flimsy and you can't fit this in the reservoir. So I found a piece of pipe laying around, or a rubber hose laying around, because we were going to try and like siphon it with an air compressor hooked up to that. I tried the Mighty Vac, which is usually used to bleed the brakes, which is right here and with a straw on the end, and it didn't really do very well at all. It didn't have hardly any suction, probably because the oil is so thick. And my next thing I tried was a soap pump, which I took the top off and found some, I think this is food grade hose or something, whatever. But anyway, I put it on top of the soap pump and I pumped out about a quarter of a quart with that, which took half hour, 45 minutes. That was just a quick $3 buy at the store. So now we're on to the Harbor Freight fluid transfer. So basically, this fits in the hose here. You want to make sure you put this on the end, or whoa, that yeah, the end. So this is the end, and this fits right into there. And I want to stick a little, keep a little bit stuck out, so down the road I can remember what I did. And then basically, I got a worm gear. You know, these are like 50 something cents. Obviously, put it down on your hose and hope it fits. Barely. And then we're going to take our quarter inch ratchet and ratchet that bad boy on there. Spill oil out. Or this thing just to fall apart in the middle of stuff. And then we have to worry about spilling stuff all over the place. All right, so that seems it's like it's on pretty tight. You can kind of like pull on it and see. I mean, there's no torque spec here. The German torque spec, guten tight. Okay, well, let's see what we're working with at the truck. The Hpop reservoir cap is right here, and mine is shiny because I could not get the old one out without using a screw extractor. So this one was put in with anti-seize. So I'm starting to put anti-seize on everything. And there's a little O-ring on it that we hope is still there, which it is. Sorry. I'm just gonna put that down here. It looks like my anti-seize did coat the threads. It was still on there pretty tight. I mean, I just pumped some of the oil out, so I might put a little bit more anti-seize on there. So, and now we have our copper tube, which you can bend it, so you can guide everything where you want. Oh yeah, that fits down there nicely. You can kind of see the oil. It's a little bit lighter than what it was. I mean, it's not black. I mean, it still is dark. Previously, it was pretty sludgy. So we're gonna go grab our container. This was the Mighty Vac container, which I wrote how much the quantities were, so I knew how much to put in here. Yeah, it's kind of hard for me to film this, but here's the handle. I have my foot on here to hold the hose down, but I can hear the fluid. Let me try to. Here it comes. Let's see if we can zoom it in down there so you can see it. That was the first gush. Yeah, it's lousy, lousy. Okay. Figures it's hiding from the camera. There, you can kind of see it now. Spewing out. Alright, well, I'm going to have to say this way is the best way so far. If you don't have any expensive equipment, so a fluid extractor or multi-use transfer pump from Harbor Freight, worm clamp, a couple pieces of a hose and copper pipe just to get down there something stiff, and you'll be good. Hpop.